Boston Dynamics and their futuristic robots. Boston Dynamics is one of the top dogs in mobile robots and is passionate about handling some of the absolute hardest challenges when it comes to robotics. The organization combined the principles of dynamic control and balance with refined mechanical designs, cutting-edge programming, and the most advanced electronics for high-performance robots equipped with perception, navigation, and intelligence. Today, our channel will take a look at Boston Dynamics and how they're making these extremely advanced robots. But before we start, make sure you smash that like button and subscribe to our channel for more awesome videos like this. Now, let's begin. What is Boston Dynamics' ambition? Who are Boston Dynamics? Established in 1992, Boston Dynamics is an American engineering and robotics design company. It was founded as a spin-off from the Massachusetts Institute of Technology. Boston Dynamics has been owned by the Hyundai Motor Group since December 2020, which is based in Waltham, Massachusetts. The robotics company is most popular for the development of a series of dynamic, highly mobile robots, including Spot, BigDog, Handle, and Atlas. What makes Boston Dynamics remarkable is its ambition to construct dynamically stable, legged machines, and before anyone else in the world. It was Marc Raibert who started tackling this issue for almost 35 years.
Is that the workspace is essentially infinite.
For such a long time, they've been inspired and have worked towards this goal. For that reason, they've developed techniques to make robots work that we can't find in any textbook or specialized article. The outcome? They now know how to create walking robots of any shape, size, power plant, or actuator style. These one-of-a-kind designs enable their robots to perform automated tasks in unstructured environments and conquer landscapes inaccessible to others. Making robots with cutting-edge mobility, dexterity, and intelligence is Boston Dynamics' core interest. They've long believed that adequate mobility to access both the natural and man-made world would require the use of legs. The commonly referred to dull, dirty, and hazardous tasks don't happen exclusively on a neatly organized factory floor. They spring up in the natural world and in existing foundations. Because of this, they wanted to assemble a robot that could go where people go. These are places where being effective requires deftly moving through staircases, rough and rocky paths, entryways, catwalks, or narrow, cluttered passages. The motivation for the robots comes from the natural world, while the design is ultimately spurred by functionality. Their robots ended up moving like people and animals, not because they were intended to look like people and animals, but because they were made to move effectively. Balance and dynamic movement are qualities we've previously only seen in animals. People generally associate it with lifelike movement due to the organic nature of dynamically stable motion. Their robots can explore intense, unstructured, unknown, or adversarial terrain with ease, partly in light of the advantages of dynamic motion. Steps, holes, ground-level obstructions such as cabling and staged materials, and small height differences in flooring limit wheeled and tracked robots. As for legged robots, these conditions don't present the same difficulties. The environment can't be adjusted to the machine, and therefore the machine must be skilled in navigating the environment as it comes. Pretty cool, right? But what about the use of artificial intelligence? Spot, the autonomous four-legged robot from Boston Dynamics, is perhaps the most well-perceived robot of its sort. Spot utilizes a ton of intelligence to navigate the natural world. Furthermore, they call this athletic intelligence as the robot strolls, avoids obstacles, climbs stairs, navigates difficult terrain, and autonomously follows predetermined routes without constant input from operators. Spot can distinguish stairs, edges that can cause it to trip, and body obstacles due to its exceptionally simple understanding of the environment, enabling it to walk more steadily. Using payload ports and developer tools, applications such as halting an autonomous mission when a person is close by, or responding to voice commands can be added to the robot. Now that we've taken a look at who and what Boston Dynamics is and does, let's dive into their most famous robots. We'll start with Spot. Boston Dynamics released Spot in September 2019. Their likable little robot was planned as a versatile mobile machine suited for an assortment of applications. Boston Dynamics intends to offer accessories to Spot, such as a 6 degrees of freedom arm. This seemingly small addition can allow Spot to grasp items and open entryways. As for its hardware, it's almost essentially custom designed. It has sensor modules for perception, as well as robust processing boards for control. These sensors are located on the front, back, and sides of Spot's body. You can also find in each module a pair of stereo cameras, a wide-angle camera, and a texture projector, which improves 3D sensing in low light. Using the navigation technique known as SLAM, or simultaneous localization and mapping, the sensors permit the robot to utilize it to get around independently. Spot can likewise be directed by a remote operator with a game-style controller along with its autonomous behavior. Even when in manual mode, the robot doesn't fail to impress, as it still displays a high degree of independence. Spot will circumvent any obstacle that's ahead. It can likewise climb stairs when required. Without any input from the operator, the robot can go into these operating modes and then perform the correct actions completely on its own. But what about going down the stairs? Well, Spot walks backwards when going down a stairwell, an approach that provides greater stability, according to Boston Dynamics. The robot can stroll forward, sideways, and in reverse, and run at a top speed of 1.6 meters per second. This is because Spot's legs are backed by 12 custom DC motors, each designed to provide high torque. It also allows turning in place, crawling, and pacing. Spot can do an assortment of tasks. He can make digital twins, review progress on construction sites, and can self-sufficiently compare building information modeling. Spot can be driven remotely or get alerted on risky situations or inspect hazardous packages at a distance. That's not all. He can either be driven remotely to perform inspections in radiation-dense or electrified areas, or he can create autonomous routes himself to give a view of plant operations. The healthcare industry can likewise utilize Spot to triage patients, deliver medications and food, or disinfect rooms from afar. Now, let's talk about Atlas. Boston Dynamics' biggest superstar is Atlas, a 150-centimeter-tall humanoid that's equipped for impressive athletic feats. The unique framework gives the 80-kilogram robot abilities that don't seem to be feasible for such a large humanoid to do, and has the strength needed to perform impressive acrobatic flips and leaps. But how is this possible? The company engineered a compact, yet capable, hydraulic system from scratch that drives its 28 actuators. These actuators are fundamentally chambers filled with pressurized liquid that can drive a piston with extraordinary force. Their superior performance is due in part to custom servo valves that are significantly lighter and smaller than the aerospace models that Boston Dynamics had been utilizing in earlier designs. The innards of an Atlas are loaded up with these hydraulic actuators, as well as the lines of liquid that connect them. When one of those lines bursts, the robots bleed out the hydraulic fluid, which happens to be the color red. The current version of Atlas was built for the DARPA Robotics Challenge in 2015. And is an intensive upgrade of the first model that's lighter and more coordinated. The company utilized industrial-grade 3D printers to design key structural parts, giving the robot a more noteworthy strength-to-weight ratio than prior designs. The current Atlas can also accomplish something that its predecessor could not, and that's getting up after falling. An operator provides general steering by means of a manual controller, while the robot utilizes its stereo cameras and LiDAR to adjust to changes in the environment. Atlas's control software doesn't explicitly advise the robot how to move its joints, but rather it uses mathematical models of the underlying physics of the robot's body and how it interacts with the environment. When hopping over an obstacle or doing acrobatic stunts, the robot utilizes not only its legs, but also its upper body, swinging its arms to propel itself. In short, Atlas relies on its entire body to balance and move. But what was Atlas built for? Atlas was built to assist with emergency services and search and rescue operations. It was intended to perform tasks such as opening entryways, shutting off valves, and operating powered equipment in conditions where humans could not survive. With such power Atlas has, the Department of Defense stated in 2013 that it had no interest in utilizing the robot for offensive or defensive warfare. Thank goodness. Atlas is additionally able to complete a number of tasks, such as drive a utility vehicle at sites, travel dismounted across rubble, and remove debris obstructing entryways. It can also open an entryway and enter a building independently, climb an industrial ladder, and travel across an industrial walkway, use tools or devices to break through solid panels, locate and close a valve near a leaking pipe, and even turn on a valve and connect a fire hose to a standpipe. Next on our list is the robot called Handle. In early 2017, the first version of Handle was introduced by Boston Dynamics, describing it as an R&D robot. The robot had two wheels instead of feet, and the robot could travel at 15 kilometers per hour and jump 1.2 meters vertically. To operate both electric and hydraulic actuators, the robot uses electric power. It also relied on the same balance, dynamics, and mobile manipulation principles used by the company's legged robots. The company introduced a new version of Handle in April 2019. The new version is a mobile manipulation platform for logistics applications and is designed to pick up heavy loads while occupying a small amount of space, allowing it to fit in tight spaces. Handle can independently assemble and disassemble pallets and handle boxes that weigh up to 15 kilograms. It tracks markers on the pallets and locates boxes for grasping and placing using its onboard vision system. Pretty clever, right? And lastly, we have BigDog. In 1995, the company started developing BigDog with funding from DARPA. Many ideas conceived by Raibert were used for the robot at the Legg Laboratory. Specialists from NASA's Jet Propulsion Laboratory and Harvard University collaborated on the project, and the goal was to build an autonomous vehicle with legs equipped with mobility superior to that of current tracked and wheeled vehicles. The ideal design would travel anywhere a human or animal could walk or run using their legs for several hours and carry its payload and fuel. The company assembled and tested many versions of BigDog, and the company announced a bigger, stronger version called AlphaDog was under development in 2011. BigDog is equipped with dynamic walking and can travel over rubble, snow, ice, water, mud, and slopes up to 35 degrees, as well as carrying payloads of 150 kilograms. It's pretty exciting to see robots starting to be incorporated into our daily lives. And who knows, maybe in the next few years, you could even get the chance to buy one for yourself. What are your favorite Boston Dynamics robots? Do you think they're creepy, amazing, or just plain inspiring? Let us know in the comments down below. I hope you enjoyed today's video. If you did, make sure you subscribe to our channel and turn on the bell icon to stay updated whenever we release a new video. Other than that, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.